Welcome to Viking Basketball with Barret Peery as the Portland State Vikings are finally home this week to play Big Sky Conference games against Montana State on Thursday and Montana on Saturday. And we're here with first-year head coach Barret Peery. We're going to talk a little bit about the season. We're going to talk a little bit about Big Sky Conference play and the upcoming opponents. And coach, first of all, congratulations on the great start. And let's just talk real briefly about that. Off to an 11-5 record going into this week. And I think maybe back in September, if somebody told you you'd get to 11-5 at this point, you might have been pretty pleased.
Yeah, I'm pleased with our body of work right now. 11-5 is great, you know, and our guys have gotten a lot of credit for, you know, what they've done. Obviously, we've played a very challenging schedule with all these different road places that we've gone, and you know, we've got a 6-3 road record. We won all of our games at home. We had a good showing in the PK80, which I think really gave us momentum as well as confidence for things that we could do with this basketball team. You know, and so I like where we're at. We've been able to use a lot of different lineups. I think we've also weathered a storm as far as random lineups with injuries. You know, we've been a little thin at times, especially in the big guy part of things with our team. And our guys have really responded. We put guys in spots, and they've really done a good job.
And I was going to address that. You know, one thing that maybe a lot of people don't realize is that you have dealt with a lot of injuries early in the season. Maybe at this point might be about as healthy as you've been, not that you're completely healthy. You've plugged a lot of guys in at different times, and a lot of guys have led you to victories up and down the lineup.
Yeah, I think you can look at any night this year where guys have contributed, different guys have contributed and impacted wins. If you'd have told me back in the summer that Bryce and North would be playing a lot of four in December, I would have said, you're crazy. They're never going to play four. Those guys have played a lot of four in December. And so it's kind of good to be back in our normal lineup. You know, I think that we tried to plug back our normal lineup this last week or so, and it felt like we hadn't done it in a while. And it took away from our momentum a little bit. But bottom line is we've been on the road a lot, and our guys have really had to weather a lot of storms.
Talk a little bit about maybe a little of the mental challenge that there's been. 7 of the last 8 games on the road, 12 of 16 on the road overall. A little bit of the mental challenge your players have had to undertake, and maybe the coaching staff.
Oh, I agree 100%. You know, I don't think we're ever going to make excuses. You know, you've heard me say many times, we don't care where we play or who we play. You know, especially we've had to have that mantra this year with not having a real home court. But I think we have cared about how we felt. And we've been tired. We've been banged up. And Idaho was a perfect example on Saturday. I really was concerned about one thing, and that was just us having enough gas in the tank to be able to get through that game. And I don't even know if it was physical. It was more mental. Just, you know, the guys are trying to figure out, okay, what hotel are we in today? What town are we in today? What time does the bus leave continuously? And I was really proud of how they responded.
Okay, the preseason, pretty well documented, a great preseason, 10-3 in non-conference games for the Vikings. Big Sky play begins on December 30th. Right out of the gates, you lose one after playing pretty competitively with Sacramento State. They win it in the second half. You lose another close one at Eastern Washington and then win a great one at Idaho on Saturday. And I think probably the one common theme through that, you continue to play that great pressure defense. You continue to try to create those opportunities, but maybe a little of that fatigue set in. The shooting hasn't quite been there in those first three games.
Yeah, you know, if you know what we try to study stat-wise, you know, with the offensive glass, with turning people over, free throw attempts, Sacramento State and Eastern Washington, we had great stat lines. But when it was time to make shots, we just couldn't get the ball to go down. You know, I think we were 3-for-20 against Eastern Washington from three. We turned them over 20 times. Took 19 more shots than them and lose the game. That's almost impossible to do.
Yeah.
And we did. And so, you know, we didn't get those big shots. We didn't finish around the rim or hit those threes like we had been and so used to have been doing, you know, throughout the preseason. Our people had seen our guys make those shots over and over and over. And so I think one of the big things was is as we broke through at Idaho on Saturday is we hit just enough of those, even though we didn't maybe turn them over as much. You know, that Idaho game was how I pictured that Idaho game to be for the last 90 days. I thought that would be a slugfest between two good teams and be really tough. You know, on paper, I think everybody would say that we had a really good chance to beat Sac, a really good chance to beat Eastern, and you probably won't beat Idaho. and it was the opposite. But I think what you're learning quickly is if anybody has any media opportunities at all to turn on their TV or look at their phone, you better show up every night in conference play, because it doesn't matter what league you're in. You know, people are going on the road and losing games or losing home games. You got to show up. You know, we saw, you know, people that we've played, you know, Cal goes and beats Stanford the other night at Stanford, and then Stanford sweeps UCLA and USC. And it doesn't matter who it is. You know, Michigan State goes and plays their first road game yesterday and loses to Ohio State by 20. So you got to show up.
Yeah, conference play, always a different animal, always a different level of intensity because of how important it is. And before we move on to this week's game, let's just run through that last few seconds at Idaho and got the miss, got the rebound, got the ball up court. What did you want your team to do to have a chance to tie or go ahead and win the game? And in your case, you were fortunate to have a chance to go ahead and win the game, only trailing by one on that last possession.
Well, I'd given the guys a great three-point shot play to use, because I thought they were going to make both free throws.
Yeah.
And before I knew it, the first free throw was already missed. So the guys came down. They ran and doubled north. You know, he pushed it ahead and found Strickland in the corner, who's a good shooter for us, and a guy that we have confidence in to shoot the ball and make shots. You know, Strick misses that, and Boo Boo goes to the glass and finishes it, you know, and puts it in. But, you know, I felt like that was a lot like the Portland game, where our guys just kept battling and battling and battling. And with how we play and with what we do, you just kind of have to keep chipping away at it, and good things will happen, and we did.
And that was really textbook, like you expected. The little guy in the middle of the key was going to make the game-winning shot,
you know,
in a crowd.
As you know, in our system, if Strickland and Boo Boo were in together, Boo Boo gets to go to the offensive glass and Strickland has to get back. So it worked out perfect.
And there it is. Okay, let's talk about basketball this week. Portland State taking on Montana State in Montana. And those two teams tied for first place in the Big Sky. Montana State 11-6, 4-0. Montana 11-5, 4-0. And of course, the one thing you look at in the Big Sky, a guard-oriented league, very talented guards on every team. You got to look at the guards on these two teams, and we'll start with Montana State. Tyler Hall, who many think might be the best player in the league, and his running mate, Harold Frey. How are the Vikings going to deal with that matchup?
Fantastic guard combo. You know, they're getting, what, 36 points a game, I believe, between the two of them together. And, you know, Hall can go and score it from anywhere. He's going to shoot it any time, anywhere. You know, I think as we put this scouting report in over the next 72 hours, we're going to basically tell the guys when he gets off the bus, he's looking to shoot. And so we got to find him. And then Frey, you know, his name doesn't come up a lot simply because of who he plays with. You know, with Hall, he gets a lot of love, but this Frey kid is really good. You know, he can really handle it. He can make plays, and he does a good job. He's got good toughness. He's clever. He's clever. Great range. So that combo of those two guys, you know, for us, we always look at guards and say, okay, they got to handle pressure. They got to handle our defense. We're going to have to run multiple guys at them and try to wear them down and keep coming at them for 40 minutes.
And Tyler Hall, just to finish that thought, leading the Big Sky, 63 three-point field goals made this year. And then you look at the Montana Grizzlies, and they have Ahmad Rory, Michael Ogine, a couple of great guards, and now they got a big fella that they didn't have last year, Jamara Coe, who's played very, very well. But how about that guard combination?
Again, you know, almost a broken record with what I said earlier, you know, except for maybe Rory makes more plays off the bounce, you know, Hall is a little bit more of a deep shooter, but again, another great combo, experienced group, a group that's played together a lot, and they obviously have to have great confidence. They have good overall records, and they're both 4-0 coming into here, so they both went on the road the first week, beat Southern Utah, beat NAU, and then they went home and took care of business against two good teams with North Dakota and Northern Colorado, so they should feel good coming to Portland, and it's our job to mess it up.
Okay, it's Monday as we record this. Montana State Thursday night, trying to get your guys fresh. We have Michael Mayhew here in the background taking a few extra shots, which is good to see. Got to get your guys fresh. Got to get your guys back maybe in rhythm a little bit shooting. What are we working on this week?
You know, I think the biggest thing is we need to be fresh. You know, you said that word first, and we need to be fresh. You know, conference play can be a real grind with all this road travel. We got to get fresh. We got to get healthy. The cold and flu bug is going through our team a little bit, but we'll be ready when it's time Thursday. There's always specific things to work on with these teams, you know, little things within a scouting report to prepare for. But I think any coach would tell you that it's all about us. It's all about making sure we do what we do well and making our, you know, our game plan decisions on the fly, but making sure our system and how we play is in when we play the game.
Keys to success this weekend?
keys to success. Obviously, those great guards can't have big-time nights. If they do, then you might be in trouble. We have to have great pressure on the ball, especially with those scores, and then we need to run when we stop them.
All right, there it is. Head coach Barret Peery. The Vikings, once again, Thursday night, Montana State, 8 p.m. Saturday, Montana, 1 p.m., and once again, Portland State playing home games this year at Lewis and Clark College. Free parking up there. Come on up and see the Vikings play. The Vikings will play 9 home games here over the next 2 months. This has been Viking Basketball with Barret Peery. Get all your information at govikes.com.